Summer solstice is a strange point in the year for me. I mean, we all know that it's the time when we have the longest day and the days start to get shorter, but that's not why. Though I suppose symbolically it says something quite similar. Many, many years ago, when I was young and foolish and naive, I did something, made a decision on that day, which was an unwise decision. A decision I actually knew was unwise at the time. But when you are young and naive and foolish, you don't think about consequences in quite the same way that you do when you've had to live some of them. So even though it's like I the last couple of days I've been feeling a little bit on edge, and I haven't known why, which is a bit stupid because it's fairly obvious. But it's odd because, you know, the real in your face consequences of that decision were gone long ago. But some things that we do have lifelong consequences, even if our life doesn't continue on that particular trajectory. Some things that we do in life, those decisions do echo through the rest of our lives, whether we like it or not. And how we deal with that is quite significant as well. You know, a lot of the work that I've done has been in helping people to relinquish lessons that they've learnt that aren't appropriate, that don't apply to everything, or wounds that they haven't quite recovered from, and so on. But I also, you know, and that can work extremely well, you can change your attitude. But I'm also aware that certain things leave scar tissue, and scar tissue is not as malleable, as flexible, as adaptable as healthy tissue. And a lot of that is to do with the pathways that our minds and our emotions have taken, and so the assumptions that we will therefore make, or the protections that we may place around ourselves in order to avoid those kind of things taking place again, even if they couldn't. Quite often I have found that symbolic gestures have helped me. They've somehow been able to connect up what's going on in the recesses of my mind, in my unconscious, in my conditioned reflexes that I am not consciously necessarily informed about, and my conscious, trying to make the changes so that those reflexes don't just sort of kick off automatically. You know, starting again with things. You know, some things that's relatively easy to do, isn't it? And other things it's a lot harder to do for all sorts of different reasons. I mean, I'm not going to go into the details of this, but there was no way that I could recover from the consequences for years, many years. It just wasn't feasible or practical. Sometimes you just have to get on with life, don't you? More often than not, you just have to get on with life. And then you, over a long time, can unpick and change your perceptions and maybe learn some more productive, constructive lessons about whatever that aspect of your life may be. So I thought I would open this out a little bit. I would raise it and open it out, even though in some respects it's very personal, it's also universal, because these sorts of things affect us all. You know, we're all either haunted by something or impacted by something, affected in the long term by something. We become cynical or jaded or overcautious or overreactive. And how we can adjust that and change that is meaningful and important.